of an interface between the fluid that has a mass flow across the interface. And we don't have a... What is the problem? This one is a problem. Do you want to disconnect? Okay. No, not here. No, it's not going to work. It's a different USB port. It's a different port. Okay, this is my and it works. And after my talk, we proceed to the closure of the program. So I will try to finalize everything maybe in 15, 20 minutes. So hydrodynamic instabilities control a variety of processes in fluids, plasmas, and materials, including formation of hot spots and inertial confinement fusion, compression of opposing Z-pinches, core collapse supernova, propagation of nuclear flame front and thermonuclear flames, supersonic flows, premixed and not premixed combustion, as well as detonation to deflagration transition. Material dynamics is often characterized by strong acceleration, sharply and changing, and sharp changes of scalar and vector flow fields, and by relatively small influence of dissipation and diffusion. This leads to formation of interfaces or fronts that separate flow heterogeneities or phases at macroscopic continuum scales. And in my personal view, the formation of a phase and the transport, actually of a multi-phase flows, is maybe one of the most interesting and productive areas of research for the future. To capture the transport of mass momentum and energy, a boundary value problem should be solved. And in this work, we, while still working in a far field approximation, and while looking at a field separating incompressible ideal fluids of different densities, we identify two quantitatively different behaviors of the front, stable and unstable, depending upon whether the energy flux produced by the perturbed front is large or small compared to the flux of kinetic energy across the planar front. Landau solution for the Landau Dorée instability is consistent with one of these cases. In principle, the front evolution can be studied in a continuous approximation, and this is what is commonly done in a diffusive approximation. In this case, initial value problem is being solved. Solution is relatively easy to find. However, to describe the dynamics reliably, detailed information on the structure of the front is required, and this was a discussion presented today at the lecture of Professor Golub. This information is often a challenge to obtain and quantify in experiments and simulations. Therefore, the models necessarily use adjustable parameters, and the use of these adjustable parameters may influence predictive capability of the model and bound the parameter regime. On the other hand, the front evolution can be studied in a sharp boundary approximation. In this case, a boundary value problem is being solved. Solution is usually hard to find. Flow diagnostics, but the advantages of this approach is that the flow diagnostics is conducted away from the interface or from the front. Adjustable parameters are not employed. The model obeys the conservation laws, has higher predictive capability, and can be applied in a broader parameter regime when compared to diffusive models. We consider the evolution of a front that has a mass flow across the interface, and for us, the front is a boundary separating two fluid phases. So we are not talking about a flame, even though this type of dynamics is usually studied within combustion, actually considered in the dynamics of the front and the premixed flame. There was a lot of work done on premixed combustion, and especially on the stabilities and instabilities, because the first works that have been appeared there may be dated by 1944 by Landau, who considered the flame front as a hydrodynamic discontinuity and found that the front is unconditionally unstable, and the growth rate of this Landau instability is proportional to the velocity of the heavy fluid and inversely proportional to the wavelengths. This result contradicted some experiments because a stable front exists and observed in the laboratory. Several approaches were applied to resolve the paradox, including the seminal works of Markstein, Sivashinsky, Williams, Clavin, Peters, and many others. And indeed, there were extensive studies and seminal works which are listed here, and it's only probably a very small list of the papers that we would like to refer. And in fact, a number of stabilization mechanisms for Landau-Dorée instability have been proposed, and one of them has been discussed today in Professor Golub's lecture. However, as a rule, the idea is such that the complex transports of the temperature and mass at the interface, as well as various diffusive mechanisms, may potentially stabilize the front, and if the front is thick, then it is stable. So in our work, we again, consider the two incompressible ideal of fluid. So in a sense, it's a model mathematical problem. But we justify it with the use of a far field approximation. We are not staying in the vicinity of the interface. We don't look at it like that. We look at it like that. So in this case, the conservation of mass, momentum, and energy governs the dynamics. It's a, in principle, three-dimensional motion with the unsteady, and there is a density, velocity, pressure, and energy fields that describe the dynamics. Energy, it can involve internal energy plus V squared term, where W is a specific enthalpy. We may introduce a local scalar function that describes the interface, presuming that the first derivatives of this function exist, and that the light fluid is located in one region, and the heavy fluid is located in the other region. In the bulk, the flow fields have this form. There is a mass flow across the interface. Therefore, the standard Rankine-Gubonian condition should balance fluxes of mass, two components of momentum and energy across the interface. So the front is presumed to be planar and steady. In the moving frame of reference, there are the boundary conditions at the outside boundaries of the domain. And the initial conditions include perturbation of the flow fields at the interface. As I mentioned, the fluids are ideal, incompressible, have control, constant internal energies. We, of course, may linearize these dynamics, consider small perturbations around the uniform flow fields, and reduce our Rankine-Gubonian conditions to zero-order terms, which are presented here, as well as to the first-order terms, which include conditions for the velocities in the bulk, as well as the conditions at the interface, which are given here. Then the structure of the solution is actually based on the observation that was proposed by Landau, such that the velocity of the heavy fluid is potential, whereas velocity of the light fluid has a potential and vertical component, and there is an interface perturbation. So we essentially have four independent variables. So potential of the heavy fluid, potential of the light fluid, vertical field of the light fluid, as well as the interface perturbation. And there are four different equations: conservation of mass, normal and tangential components of momentum, and energy. So we may introduce the wave vector, substitute all these expressions into our governing equations, count what would be the typical characteristic wavelengths of the vortex field, calculate what would be the pressure perturbations, and then all this is reduced to a certain linear 4x4 matrix, MR, where actually the R is represented, is built from the functions containing the potentials of the heavy, light fluid, interface perturbation, and vertical component of the heavy field. Definitely, it's a 4x4 matrix. We can identify its eigenvectors, eigenvalues. So even though this is kind of straightforward approach, Landau used somewhat different approach. He considered the boundary conditions that balance mass to components of momentum at the interface, and he didn't consider a question for energy transfer. However, four variables still require four equations. And referring to the constant of the flame velocity, Landau employed additional condition at the front, which was called the continuity of the normal component of perturbed velocity, or this. So even though it's written in a very simple mathematical form, it really has a long physics description. As soon as we employ this condition, it would immediately lead to continuity of perturbed pressure at the front and modify the boundary conditions in the following way. So as a result, if we would consider that R large is a ratio between the fluids, we actually, from the system of our governing equations, which is involved this, this, and this equation, we may derive the characteristic eigenvalues, one of which is corresponds to the Landau Darian instability, which is here. There are a few interesting things here, and one of them was discussed in the previous talk, in the talk on Wednesday, that in fact, despite we have four variables and 4x4 matrix, there are actually only two conditions which are classically considered. In fact, actually, there is a sort eigenvalue which is not presented here for simplicity because it has a zero perturbation fields. However, still the number of eigenvalues appears to be smaller than the dimension of the system. And in fact, Landau system is indeed degenerate because one of the conditions, specifically this condition, is a kinematic condition rather than dynamic condition on the side of physics. And on the side of mathematics, it actually, with this degeneracy can be seen from the form of the matrix. On the other hand, if we look at the Landau Darian instability and actually look at the structure of the flow field, we will see that actually this solution has three important properties. First, a strongly coupled potential and vertical components of the dynamics and the interface perturbation. The characteristic length scale of this vertex, actually of this vertical field, is very large, And in fact, actually, it approaches infinity when density ratio approaches 1. It also approaches infinity when density ratio, approaches infinity. And it has a typical maximum size of the land scale at this specific value of the density ratio. However, a remarkable property is that the for ideal incompressible fluid, the Landau solution is incompatible with the condition for energy balance across the front. And this can be found by means of simple calculations, because if you will substitute these equations into the equation for energy balance, and by performing some calculations, we will realize very quickly that there is indeed our energy equation is reduced to the requirement of the zero and perturbed enthalpy jump, which is here. And given that our internal energy does not change, this essentially would mean that our P divided by rho should have a zero jump at the interface. But because P is constant and rho is not constant, this condition actually appears to be incompatible with the momentum balance. Thus, Landau solution requires energy imbalance across the front. And probably for the flames, this is OK, because flames are indeed known to produce the energy. And in fact, if we will be trying to see what kind of scaling can be applied to quantify this energy imbalance, we see that there are two possible mechanisms, because one of them is a kind of traditional scaling, which is presumes that our enthalpy perturbations scale as zero values of the enthalpy. And in this case, in fact, accounting for that our delta omega large would be proportional to delta T, essentially would be proportional to delta in the density ratio, it would be might be something on the order of R minus 1. On the other hand, we might apply the scaling which is associated with the pressure. And in this case, our jump in enthalpy may be scaled like this. So it might be scaled with the kinetic energy. Dimensional parameters can be introduced and can differentiate between these cases. To see importance of the energy balance for the front stability, we may further analyze the conserved system, which balances all transport, including mass, two components of momentum and energy. And it indeed can be found that this flow is stable, because there are the modes that include oscillatory modes that has these typical eigenvectors, as well as there are the modes which describe which has described the steady solution. And while both for Landau system and for this solution, there is an unstable mode, it has a zero perturbation fields. So in this case, we have a completely different vertical dynamics. And I will not be just balancing it. I just would like to point attention that in this case, this vertical component is effectively decoupled from the interface perturbation. Now, if you would like to model essential effect of energy imbalance produced by the perturbed front within the frame of an ideal incompressible fluid, we just need to introduce additional source term, which is producing energy, which is done with this term. And then we essentially derive our equation, governing equation for the eigenvalues, which can be considered in two different limiting cases. So in fact, actually, what is this? It's a term which is coming from the balance dynamics. What is this? It's a term which is coming from Landau degree instability. So when f is small, this term is essentially gone, and we have a balance dynamics. So this is actually oscillatory stable oscillations. When f is large, become very large approaching infinity, then this term should be very small, leading to generation of Landau degree instability. And this type of equations can be essentially found and analyzed in certain limiting cases, including large density contrast, large energy perturbation, small density contrast, small density perturbations, et cetera. What is more important is that what I would like to point your attention to the effect of gravity on the balance dynamics rather than imbalance dynamics. In this case, we may actually turn on the gravity field, repeat the same exercise, analyze the stability, again, because it's just a linear problem, it's the same structure of the flow fields. And what we actually will derive that the balance dynamics, which is a potential dynamics, it has a very interesting flow structure, because first of all, it has a zero component for the vertical field, both here and here. On the other hand, it has a it has coupled components of the potential motion of the light and heavy fluid to the interface perturbation. But what is interesting, it has a completely different growth rate, completely different dispersion relations than is described in the classical book of Landau and Lifshitz. And in fact, what we can see in this situation is that, for this solution, which is omega 3 marked here, some vertical dynamics can be implemented with a special choice of the dynamic of the initial conditions. However, just for standard, for general initial conditions that we may observe here, There is the gravity-induced dynamics, which are solution omega 1 and omega 2. Here are essentially potential dynamics. And this potential dynamics becomes unstable only when the gravity field increases a certain threshold, which depends on the density ratio in this particular form. In other words, the larger the density ratio, the bigger gravity is required for us for the flow to destabilize. In a sense, actually, this type of approach might be applied further to model ablative Rayleigh-Taylor instability. I think probably the gravity-induced dynamics can be, first of all, it's interesting that despite we consider the interface that has a mass flow across the interface, and we would not probably expect it to be similar to classical Rayleigh-Taylor instability, but in fact, it appears to be quite similar to classical Rayleigh-Taylor instability in that sense that the flow is potential in both cases. So we don't have any bulk vorticity compared to Landau-Dorée instability. On the other hand, it's quite quantitatively different from the classical Landau-Dorée instability, at least in the values of the growth rate, which is given here. And for fluids with a highly contrasting densities, R omega has this particular form, and typical gravity that has a threshold value is given by this expression. For fluids with similar densities, we have a somewhat different expression, which also can be calculated. So we see that when we balance in the dynamics of the interface that has a mass flow across it and it's in gravity field, then this interfacial dynamics is unstable when the gravity value is large enough, or when for a fixed value of g, when the perturbation wavelength is large enough. And in this sense, actually, this offers us great opportunities for stabilization of the front. On the other hand, if we'll still keep on going with an imbalance dynamic such as Landau-Dorée instability in a gravity field, we may apply similar mechanisms and as it was discussed before, and consider, again, limiting cases when our energy imbalance is very small, which is described by the letter F, and in this case, we have our limiting expressions that we have just been discussing, or consider another case when the energy perturbations produced by the perturbed front is very large, and in this case, we are transferring to the Landau-Dorée instability, and this is exactly that expression that is given in volume 6 of Landau-Lifshitz course. It's interesting, though, that this imbalance solution has a, which is classical Landau-Dorée instability in the gravity field, it has a somewhat different physics properties because, first of all, it's unbalanced for any gravity value. It does not have any stabilization mechanism. It does not have a cutoff or a threshold value of gravity in contrast to what the balanced solution has. And while the imbalanced solution in gravity field looks like Rayleigh-Taylor instability, it has a completely different flow field. Specifically, for this solution, the potential and vertical components of the motion are strongly coupled, and there is a large-scale vortex in the bulk of the light fluid behind the front. We definitely may consider various limiting cases as I would do it here, and I probably will proceed to the discussion and would mention that we consider it essentially a linear problem of the effect of the energy flux as well as the mass flux on the stability of an interface with and without gravity field, and we identified some interesting properties that have been not discussed before. So, and again, so in a far field approximation, we found two different behavior of a hydrodynamic discontinuity, which is stable and unstable. We found that the flow stability depends on the energy flux produced by the perturbed front, and Landau-Dorée instability is consistent with one of these cases.